Today, the president told millions of people what he wants. He said it plainly and directly, and in fact, he wrote it down. So he put some thoughts into it. Now, the problem for the president and the White House is that what he wants and what he said, what he actually wrote, it freaked a lot of people out today. Because if you're looking for evidence that the president is trying to obstruct justice, this is potentially one more piece of evidence. Here's the tweet. This is a terrible situation, and Attorney General Jeff Sessions should stop this rigged witch hunt right now before it continues to stain our country any further. Bob Mueller is totally conflicted, and his 17 angry Democrats that are doing his dirty work are a disgrace to USA. Now, let me just repeat the key sentence there. Attorney General Jeff Sessions should stop this rigged witch hunt. That's what the president said. He said, stop it right now. Now, it sounds like the president, who is chief executive, wants to see Jeff Sessions, who works for him, and the Russia investigation ended right now. That is what it sounds like, because that is actually what the president wrote. Unless, of course, you believe his press secretary and TV lawyer who scrambled to try and convince the public that what the president said about what he wants to see happen and happen right now was in no way a directive to actually make it happen and happen right now. No, according to them, it was only some guy's opinion, the guy who happens to be president, commander-in-chief. Now, stopping this investigation, it's complicated. Sessions would have to recuse himself. Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein might have to be fired. There might be a court challenge or political blowback. But if the president of the United States really, truly wants a certain function of his own branch of government to stop, he can, when all is said and done, make it stop, which is why his tweet raised such concern. But again, if you believe Sarah Sanders, there's no reason for concern, because this is just someone's opinion on Twitter.
The president is stating his opinion. He's stating it clearly, and he's certainly expressing the frustration that he has with the level of corruption that we've seen from people like Jim Comey, Peter Strzok, Andrew McCabe. There's a reason that the president's angry, and frankly, most of America is angry as well, and there's no reason he shouldn't be able to voice that opinion.
See, the president is just like most Americans, angry, speaking out on Twitter from the White House as president and chief executive, as Jeff Sessions' boss. But hey, he said should, not must. And besides, he's just a guy with an opinion. It's not like his tweets are official statements by the president of the United States. I mean, what idiot would ever claim that?
The president is the president of the United States, so they're considered official statements by the president of the United States.
Don't, Spicer. All right, so the White House used to claim that the president's tweets are not just idle opinionating, they're official statements with all the power of the office behind them. How many times have people working for the president said that the president's tweet speaks for itself, or words to that effect? Except for today's tweet, that doesn't apparently speak for itself. That needs a spokesperson and a TV lawyer speaking for it, sweeping up after it, quietly trying to wipe it off the bottom of their shoes. When the president of the United States says that one of his subordinates should do something and do it now, how is that just one guy's opinion? It all smacks of another effort that was made recently to suggest the president didn't really say what everyone heard him say.
In a key sentence in my remarks, I said the word would instead of wouldn't. The sentence should have been, I don't see any reason why I wouldn't, or why it wouldn't be Russia. Sort of a double negative.
That actually happened. Doesn't it seem like a decade ago? Anyway, it wasn't. A little more than 2 weeks ago. And now another cleanup effort is underway. And just as before, the word twisting also comes with a dose of fact twisting. Listen.
The entire investigation is based off of a dirty, discredited dossier that was paid for by an opposing campaign and had a lot of corruption within the entity which was overseeing it, which was Peter Strzok, James Comey, Andrew McCabe. We've laid this out a number of times. I don't think that we have to go into it every single time we're in here.
Now, keep it honest, what she said is simply not true. The investigation sprang from a number of sources. Former Trump campaign advisor Carter Page was under suspicion as far back as 2013. And it was fellow advisor George Papadopoulos' drunken boasting to an Australian diplomat in London that triggered the current investigation, not the Steele dossier, dirty or not.